Alright everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep, Ventus' story, and I don't really remember exactly where it left off. I had to go and run some errands, so I'm just now getting back and reconnecting with what exactly it was I was doing, because my memory is apparently very, very poor. And let's... Alright, what do we have the most of? We have the most of Hungry Crystal, so we'll just do that. Alright. And we're gonna edit the deck, and we're gonna put Turaga. And let's go back to Melt Commands. And is there anything that we can... No, most of this stuff is not available yet. Oh, except... Nope. Why won't it let me just choose it even for the first one? I don't get it. Whatever. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and continue on. And what the hell was I doing? Okay, I'm gonna just go through here. There's question marks, so that's probably where I wanna start. Okay, where then? Okay, I'm sorry. What am I doing? What am I gonna do? Just fall, I guess? That was not helpful. Starting that Hunger Crystal, and those are lasers, which are probably just gonna kick my ass, and there's nothing I can do about it. So I'm guessing maybe I want to run out this way. Is this correct? That inverse is still so- Okay, so this is not where I go. Probably go right up there, don't I? Okay, so there's a save point and whatever this is, a mega potion. I'm gonna go ahead and save this real quick. Because you always want to save. Constantly. Just in case. And, you know, pray to God that nothing went wonky with Elgato processing the video, because if it does, then I have to start the whole game all the way the fuck over, or try to do some fancy editing that I'm not, quite frankly, not quite capable of yet. So,
End of the line! Shouldn't be here. What is it?
Alright, boss fight time. Experiment 626 is popping, throw him at the enemy. Alright. So, is it impervious to... Oh, and it's gonna heal itself with the ship. That's fucking great. That one Stitch was jumping, wasn't he? Goddamn. On to attack. Oh shit. There we go. See, I didn't even need Stitch. I got it. Granted, it's because I'm playing this on the fucking easiest setting, but who cares?
It's over! Cut it out! What's gotten into you? I see. Your wayfinder broke. Well, don't worry. Friendship's more than an object.
Friendship circle?
Mm-hmm.
Don't let the little mimic fool you. You saw for yourself what kind of monster that thing is. All it knows how to do is hurt and destroy.
Monster? He helped me stop the monster!
You must have triggered some sort of mutation, hidden in the little freak's genetic coding.
Then, friend!
That's right. We are friends.
Better say your goodbyes now, because 626 is about to be destroyed. Stop that!
Come on!
Sound the alert! Prisoners on the loose! Don't let them get away!
Where are we going?
Hyperdrive has been activated. System charging. Warning. Guidance is not functional. Navigation failure. Do not engage hyperdrive. Repeat. Do not engage.
Break formation! Get clear!
What is it? What's going on?
Well, that was actually a mildly depressing ending, so I think Ven came after Aqua's story, right? And that looks like Neverland to me. Okay, we'll go... Can I open the menu, please? Alright, so everything is at its maximum now, and that means... I still can't do shit! Alright. But I can at least add another thing here. And we'll change this one and this one. Alright. And then we'll equip hyperdrive, which is slightly better. And this was level 6, okay. That means this is level 7, and we'll go ahead and land. Name's Ventus, but everybody just calls me Ven. Huh. Guess when
I sat down to rest. I must have fallen asleep.
But where'd you come from?
Well, you see...
All right, we're going!
So long, Ben!
Hey, where are you guys off to?
Tink saw a shooting star, and we're gonna go hunt it down!
A shooting star? You mind if I come along?
Of course not! But you gotta agree to follow us!
Yeah! It's, right over... that way, by the Indian camp!
Ready, men? Forward, march!
Okay!
I'll be honest, I don't really care for Peter Pan or Neverland. This, regardless of whether you're looking at it in the game sense or in the story sense, I just never got into it as a kid. And it has nothing to do with, like, the portion of it that is racist, quite frankly. I mean, yeah, that's not good by any means, but it was a different time that it was made. But that's beside the point, honestly. I just never really cared for it. There is a theory that goes around, though, if you read the books. I have not read the books. I'm basing my opinion entirely on the Disney movie, so please keep that in mind. But there was this theory going around that Peter Pan, given that he had Tinkerbell, which is a pixie, kind of doing his bidding, that he was like a member of the Fae and was like eating the Lost Boys or something, and Captain Hook was actually trying to save them. But I mean, it's, I don't know if I agree with that theory. I'd have to read the book myself to see if there's any undertones or anything that suggests that. But it was an interesting theory, I thought. And, you know, if you're ever curious, there's like an entire section in academia, in English academia, English and media studies, completely devoted to the deconstruction of Disney movies. So pretty much any of those YouTubers that you see doing breakdowns on Disney movies and things like that, they all kind of have an academic element to them. I was never one that really enjoyed the examination through gender and women's studies. That was never really of interest to me, but historical comparisons are really interesting. Because I think it lends to the idea, if you look at Cinderella the story and Cinderella the Disney adaptation, you can see some differences between the books. Although, I mean, the Cinderella one is kind of a bad example because it's a pretty faithful adaptation to the Charles Perrault version. But if you compare it to the Grimm's Brothers fairy tale, you can kind of get a more interesting take on it. And I don't know, there's just some really interesting stuff, and Snow White is actually a pretty good example, because I believe that the Snow White tale was taken from the Grimm's Brothers and then made more palatable for mass media consumption. And I think Snow White, while it was the first Disney movie made, it was still under those strict rules in media that was, oh man, I can't remember what they were called, but I mean it was like this crazy one because movies originally were kind of risque, probably not by today's standards, but for the time period they were pretty risque, and someone didn't like that and they're like, we're gonna start censoring you, and the media was like, no, we'll censor ourselves, get the fuck out. And so they created their own rules, and so I think that's part of the reason, possibly, why Snow White was edited so heavily, at least at the end. Because in the original Grimm's Brothers version, Snow White, the evil witch was brought back to the palace of the prince that, you know, because Snow White the Princess Sage Snow White had brought the witch back to the palace, and they made they strapped iron shoes that had been over a fire, and she had to dance until she died. So, you know, fun children's stories there. Where the fuck is... How do I get back up on land? I fucking hate this thing. Great, now I don't know where I was going. We're just gonna kind of hope for the best.
Gotcha! Fire! Freeze! Thunder!
If I fall off the sledge again, I'll be pissed. You know what? Fuck you guys. I'm done. Are you serious? Waste of my fucking time. So, wrong area. I'm gonna have to go all the way back. I hate Neverland so much. I'm glad that when... I pressed the jump button! I'm glad that when, are you serious? When we get to 358 over 2 days, I'm kind of glad that they just made it cutscenes, because the gameplay in 358 over 2 days sucked. The whole missions thing didn't work, and fuck! You know what? You know what? Fuck this. I will be back when I'm on that fucking ledge again. Alright, I finally managed it with a combination of jumping and attack, even though it didn't make sense, but what the fuck ever. I don't care. I'm done. I'm done! Fuck y'all. I'm going on.
Peter Pan!
Who do we have here? Never seen you before.
I'm Ventus. Call me Vin.
Well, if you say so. Tension! Now then, men. I don't suppose you'd want to capture some real pirate treasure.
Real pirate treasure?
Sure!
Well, guess who caught sight of Hook right when he was stashing his treasure? What do you say we sneak in and grab it?
Oh, boy!
Let's go, let's go! Ow!
Tinkerbell, what's gotten into you?
We were all supposed to go hunt for a shooting star together.
Forget that. Pirate treasure is way more fun. Tink, you're coming with us. Well, that's no way to respond to an invitation. Come on, Ben. You're a better sport than her, right?
I'd love to join you, but first I want to find the shooting star.
Just watching that scene, I kind of realized what it is partly that I dislike about Peter Pan as a whole, as a story, and part of it is Peter Pan the character. Peter Pan is an asshole. I don't like Peter Pan. So, I'm going to, let's see, I'm getting to about time, so we'll just kick this thing's ass. Alright, there we go. And I will see you next time.